by the Association of Development of Financing Institutions in Asia and Pacific, Federation of Chambers of Commerce and Industry of Sri Lanka, and International Chamber of Commerce, with the assistance of Confederation of Asia Pacific Chambers of Commerce and Industry. IBON රටක සංවර්ධනය සඳහා සුළු හා මධ්‍යම පරිමාණ ව්‍යාපාරික ප්‍රචාව ඉටු කරුමේ මහඟු මෙහෙය. එහි ජාතික අවශ්‍යතාවය හඳුනාගෙන සුළු හා මධ්‍යම පරිමාණ ව්‍යාපාරිකයන්ගේ මූල්‍ය කළමනාකරණය සඳහා අවශ්‍ය කරන්නා වූ දැනුම සහ නිපුණතාවය ලබා දීමයි අද වැඩසටහනේ අරමුණ වන්නේ. මෙම වැඩසටහන ආසියානු හා පැසිෆික් කලාපීය රටවල මූල්‍යාර්ථන සංවර්ධන සංගමය ශ්‍රී ලංකා වාණිජ හා කර්මාන්ත මණ්ඩල සම්මේලනය සහ අන්තර්ජාතික වාණිජ මණ්ඩලය ආසියා පැසිෆික් වාණිජ හා කර්මාන්ත මණ්ඩල සංධානයේ සම සහයෝගය සමගින් සංවිධානය කරනු ලබනවා. First, let me introduce the head table to you. Mr. Tissa Jayaveera, President for Federation of Chambers of Commerce and Industry of Sri Lanka. Ms. Akira Dikonde, Group Head, AEFIAP Consulting. Ms. Ika Majriati, Sales Director, Storm Technologies Private Limited, Singapore. Mr. Scott Sproulet, Director, Storm Technologies Private Limited. Ms. Erlene Oshinia, Head, Projects and Programs of AEFIAP Consulting. And Ms. Cecilia Ibarra, the Head, Advocacy and Training for AEFIAP Consulting. වැඩසටහන ආරම්භ කිරීමට ප්‍රථම අපි සැම එක්ව ගයන ජාතික ගීය ගායනා කරමු. Let us stand up for National Anthem of Sri Lanka.
Good morning. Are you Boho One? Now this is something that you experience in lighting oil lamp. This is to show that we are rekindling light to give us prosperity. And when I say Are you Boho One, it means we wish you good health and long life. That is also another traditional greeting in this country. So you have two experiences this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, a crucial element for SME survival and growth is access to finance. Surveys reveal that SMEs have difficulty in borrowing from formal operations in view of their inability to present bankable proposals due to limited knowledge and skills in financial management and operational governance. Many financial providers consider SME financing as a high risk activity that generates high transaction costs and or low returns on investment. SMEs need to meet the challenge of adapting to changing financial environment and increasing complexity and extent of financial reporting, improvement of access to finance for small and medium enterprises is crucial in fostering entrepreneurship, operation, innovation, and growth. We have I happened to have dinner with Gloria Arroyo about 3 years ago. Then Andre Onsia, Senior Assistant Vice President, Head of Account Management Unit, Corporate Banking, Development Bank of Philippines. Eka Barati, Director, and Mr. Scott Spohr, Director. Cecil and Ibra, Head of Training and Advocacy Unit of the Association Development Financing Institutions, Asia Pacific, ADFP Consulting, Mr. Dinesh Panandopulli, Managing Director, CEO of Synopsys. Is he around? He is coming here because I didn't see him. Then of course there is a panel of local experts. Are they here? Right, okay, I will just, Mr. Jayaratna, Deputy Director, Industrial Development Board. Then Tushita Nakandala, Senior Manager, Development Bank in Sampath Bank. Tushar Asurumana, Manager is SME National Development Bank. Will facilitate the program in Singhala and share the knowledge and experience on Sri Lankan context. So you will have, you will hear two languages with us in the presentation. The economic and social importance of the small and medium enterprise sector is being well recognized today. The keynote address of today will be delivered by Mr. L.G. Pereira, who has, I think, served the DFCC 30 years? 34 years, so he joined the DFCC before I was born. Now we started banking from 1976, I think, together with DFCC. So, LG, we call it.
Giving discounts, and then if you have different products, you can combine them and then sell them at the bulk for discounted price. And then if you want to promote a certain product that is lagging behind, you can probably lower the price of that product so that it will catch up in terms of the demand and sales. And also offering reduced prices as a reward to early customers. For example, you're launching a new product, probably you can give the first 100 customers a discounted price. Something like that. So you have different gimmicks that you can think of in your marketing plan. Then we go to the production plan. After knowing what product you're going to sell, to whom you're going to sell it to, then the next question is how are you going to deliver that product? So this is the production plan that you're going to come up with. You have to describe the resources and the assets needed to manufacture and develop your product. We have 5 M's of a business venture. In doing a production plan, you consider your manpower, your machinery, the materials, and the money that you have to undertake all these projects and to meet your objectives in terms of producing your product. I will just go through this very fast because this is in your handout too. When you do your production plan, it would be good to have a diagram and listing down all the activities that need to be undertaken in the process of producing your goods and services. Normally, these are the symbols that are used when you come up with a flow chart of your production plan so that you would know exactly at what point you will have a bottleneck or at what point. And then you would have to have a production schedule because the production schedule is used to minimize your production time and cost. If you don't have a schedule, it's open-ended. Your people or whoever is producing the goods and services will not have any timetable. But the production schedule is a very good tool to know also which goods sell fast, and then it will also help you gauge the stocks that you would need to beef up regularly, and of course the delivery lead time. Because when somebody, so you can use this template in your production schedules, it's in your handout. And you would also have to come up with your direct material requirement, which is needed to produce your product. So these are materials that form an integral part of your finished product. You also can come up with a schedule to track your direct material requirement. And of course, your direct labor requirement is very important because it refers to the people who will be directly involved in producing your product or delivering the service that you have. So the suggested format for determining your direct labor requirement is listing down the steps on how you will produce such product or service, the activity, and then the time that you envision that this activity is going to be undertaken, and then the number of workers needed so that you don't overstaff yourself or you don't understaff yourself. I know these are very nitty-gritty activities, but these are activities that you will really need if you want your business to
study. And there is two requests from the organizers. One request is from resource persons. Since we are lagging behind in time, just they request you to be much conscious on your time period of your presentations. And the other request is to the spectators. Is there any changes in these presentations that you are hearing today and the handout that they have already provided with? Could you please provide us with your email addresses? The today's presentation will be emailed to you. Other දේශනවල තියෙන වෙනස්කම් තියෙනවා නම් ඔබට ලබා දී ඇති print out එක කරුණාකරලා ඔබේ email ලිපිනේ අපිට ලබා දෙන්න. අද දවස තුල ඔබ මේ සවන් දෙන දේශන ඔබ වෙත email කරන්න පුළුවන්. සුළුහා මධ්‍ය පරිමාණ ව්‍යාපාර සඳහා වූ මූල්‍ය කළමනාකරණය පිළිබඳ අවධානය යොමු කිරීමට හොඳම වෙලාවයි මේ. ඒ සඳහා මේ ආරාධනය සම්පත් බැංකුවේ සංවර්ධන බැංකු අංශයේ ජ්‍යෙෂ්ඨ කළමනාකරු තුසිත නාකන්දන මහතාට. Mr. තුසිත නාකන්දන will focus on the brief single introduction of the detailed English lecture on financial management for SMEs. Having obtained his diploma in banking from Institute of Bankers, possessing of more than 20 years professional experience in various divisions including regional branches network. Presently, he serves as the Senior Manager Development Banking at Sampath Bank PLC. During his career, he is being specialized in branch banking, commercial lending, SME lending and project financing. He is also an associate of Institute of Bankers. Welcome, Mr. Nakandala.
मे प्रश्न पटांग वार्ता